Our entrance hymn is 899, You Are Near, 899.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace and love of God our Father and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, to prepare our hearts to enter into the sacred mysteries, let us together call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you. We bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord said to me, "You are my servant Israel, through whom I show my glory. Now the Lord has spoken, who formed me as a servant from the womb, that Jacob may be brought back to him, and Israel gathered to him. And I am made glorious in the sight of the Lord, and my God is now my strength. It is too little, says the Lord, for you to be my servant, to raise up the tribes of Jacob and restore the survivors of Israel. I will make you a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach the ends of the earth." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Here am I, Lord, I come to do your will.
Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Paul, called to be an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, and Sothenes, our brother, to the church of God that is in Corinth, to you who have been sanctified in Christ Jesus, called to be holy, with all those everywhere who call upon the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, their Lord and ours. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Word of God became flesh and dwelt among us. To those who accepted Him, He gave power to become children of God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. John the Baptist saw Jesus coming toward him and said, "Behold, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. He is the one of whom I said, 'A man is coming after me who ranks ahead of me, because he existed before me.' I did not know him, but the reason why I came baptizing with water was that he might be made known to Israel." John testified further, saying, "I saw the Spirit come down like a dove from heaven and remain upon him. I did not know him, but the one who sent me to baptize with water told me, 'On whomever you see the Spirit come down and remain, he is the one who will baptize with the Holy Spirit.' Now I have seen and testified that he is the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord. Here am I, Lord, I come to do your will. This is a familiar responsorial psalm, but I think it is very important for us to meditate very carefully on this particular response. Here am I, Lord, I come to do your will. Whose will are we called to do? God's will. But you know, sometimes, my dear brothers and sisters, we don't like doing God's will. Whose will do we want to do? Our will. And so the truth of the matter is, we're called to do the will of God. And what is the will of God? That we be a light that points to Jesus Christ. Just as St. John the Baptist did in today's Gospel from John. John the Baptist sees Jesus coming toward him, and he says these words, and they should be familiar words to each of us. "Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world." Because they are the words we hear at every Mass prior to us coming forward to receive him. When the priest faces the people and lifts the host and the chalice and echoes those words of John the Baptist. Now, what does the word "behold" mean? Well, it means look to. But when we use it in Scripture, it doesn't mean just look to, but it also means you don't want to miss this. So what St. John the Baptist is saying to those with him, "Behold the Lamb of God." You don't want to miss the guy who takes away the sin of the world. And so he's pointing to Jesus. And so we have to ask ourselves, my dear brothers and sisters, are we pointing others to Christ? You know, we're now back into ordinary time, and ordinary times focus specifically on the life and the ministry of Jesus. And in particular, this past week, if we go back through the readings, we focus on our Lord's healing presence. He healed the paralytic. Simon Peter's mother-in-law grasped her by the hand. He drove out demons. When John the Baptist said, "Behold, Jesus has this tremendous power because he is God to bring healing and peace to our lives." And so if we want to experience that healing and peace, it is important for each of us to strive each and every single day to do the will of God. Because I don't like to say it, but when we try to do our will and not the will of God, sometimes it ends up in a train wreck. But when we follow the will of God, and people always ask me, how do I know I'm following the will of God? The answer to that question is, do you find comfort and peace? Do you find comfort and peace? Because, you know, sometimes when we make a decision after countless hours of prayer, I can tell you when a decision is finally made, you feel that peace. You know, just that same way we feel that peace and that relief when we experience the Lord's mercy in the sacrament of reconciliation. We're sometimes timid going into it, but when we leave, we rejoice. We're happy. We feel that peace. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, we are disciples of Christ. Meaning, as disciples, we follow him. And this past week, we see why we should follow him. Because he's the only one who can ultimately bring us healing and peace that we so desire. He can fulfill that void that we might have. And so the important thing is to do his will. And his will is to lead others to Christ, but also to be his hands and feet. To be his hands and feet. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, I want us to reflect today. When I elevate the sacred host and the sacred chalice, and I echo the words, and oftentimes I echo those words a little bit more, I enunciate them a little bit more. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. It was another reminder how awesome our God is. And so, and as we experience God's awesomeness, we're called, like John the Baptist, to point others towards him. To share with people what brings us hope, what brings us peace, what brings us comfort. The world cannot bring that to us. We might think it can, but it can't. It will always fall short. But God never will. God will provide for our every need as long as we are willing to do his will. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. Baptized by water and the Holy Spirit, let us draw near to God with our intentions of prayer.
For our Holy Father, our bishops, priests, and deacons, who serves God's people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For honest and wise decisions makers in finance and industry, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For adults who are seeking the new life of baptism, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For deeper love of Jesus, the Lamb of God, offered and received in this Eucharist, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are struggling with illnesses of the body, mind, or spirit, and for those tasked for caring for their needs, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those visiting our parish this weekend and for their intentions, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of the faithful departed, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intention of the holy sacrifice of the Mass being offered for Mary V. Sneringer, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Grant these requests, loving Father, which we bring to you on behalf of all people, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Our hymn at the preparation of the gifts is number 834. Here I am, Lord. 834.
Oh,
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthy in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
May the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from an unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks, you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Ronald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse of the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Thank you. Peace be with you. Sins of the world, have mercy on us, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us, have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ keep my soul safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep my soul safe for eternal life.
Our communion hymn will be number 651, Draw Near, 651.
The Body of Christ. Body of Christ. body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for a moment. I don't want to make you stand through some of this here. This weekend is our takeout turkey dinner. It runs tomorrow from 11 a.m. to 1:30 p.m., and the cost remains at $10 per meal. The parish thrift shop will also be open during those hours. If anyone is interested in a poinsettia, please feel free to take one with you. First come, first serve. Also, on Wednesday evening, I formed the parish council of our need to form a building and grounds committee to prioritize a list of things that need to be done on our grounds of our parish and to begin to formulate a plan to address the issues that are going to come on the horizon. Unfortunately, I don't have a crystal ball, but I do know the air conditioning units out here are getting very close to their shelf life, as well as the units of the outside of the school are original to the 1990 edition. So that means they're getting very close, and that means we'll probably have to address them in the future. So we need to develop a plan. Also, the rectory needs some work, repointing. There's some things else that need to be addressed. Now, as I talk about the rectory, now I'm going to need, I need some help. Yes, I'm asking for help. So number one, possibly on February 8th, barring that there's any changes to this plan, Father Dan O'Brien, who was pastor here from 2001 to 2011, will be in residence here. He is retired, but he would be living here, and he also still has his place in Delaware. So he'll be here and in Delaware. But that rectory, my dear brothers and sisters, it's been a long time since anything has been addressed. One, we are going to paint the rooms that he's going to have. He's taking the back quarters, and I'm going to move to the very front of the building, so both of us will have our privacy. What was my living room is going to become a very nice, kind of like hotel suite, because it's got both the bed and the chair and the TV in it. So who's to say it's a hotel room? But in order to do that, we also need to, we're going to be placing some floors down as well as painting. So if anybody knows how to put one of those laminate floor, wood look floors in, I greatly appreciate it. Just call the office, call Becky, call me, email me if you're interested and would like to help. Right now we're looking at February 8th. And we want to try to get most of that done as possible. I mean, I have a little less notice, but if we can do some of it, I greatly appreciate it. I pulled the carpet up in his what will be his bedroom, and I looked at it, and I go, ooh, it's that ugly 9x9 tile. No, we want to get rid of that. So, you know, we're trying to do work. It needs to be painted. We're painting over the wallpaper and, you know, start from there just to freshen up the room. There's other issues with that building, but we'll get there. But if we can freshen up, I greatly appreciate any help. So if you're inclined, just let me know. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks
be to God. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do that, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Our closing hymn will be 971, The Church of Christ in Every Age, 971.